Hey guys, so today it is Monday, May 10, 2020, and it is Victoria Day long weekend, and so happy long weekend, and so doing a Chinese food delivery. So I got this pineapple, beef and pineapple thingamajiggy, because that sounded something different, and so I don't know, like a Hawaiian style flair to it. I don't know, but it sounded different. And I don't think I've ever seen it on the menu before. And then I'll do this a ginger chicken. Got my egg foo young. And I got fried rice. And so, yeah, so just digging in, you guys. So I don't remember if I've ever ordered egg foo young from this place before, but they loaded it up good, really, really nicely. Inside. Oh my gosh. Really, really beautiful one. Like, this is like the best egg foo young I've ever ordered so far, because sometimes the restaurants, they make it very watery. This is very good. Yum. Hey guys, and so happy Victoria Day, long weekend, and so that is all I know because all these years as an adult person in Canada, I never know what Victoria Day is all about. It's just like one of those weird holidays here, and then it's like the people at my work is telling me, "Oh, you want to work today? You want to work today? It's a long weekend." I'm like, "Huh?" It's like every single year or every time they ask me, I'm like, "What long weekend is it?" And then they're like, "It's Victoria Day long weekend." I'm like, "Huh?" I'm like, "Whatever," because like my job is open 364 days a year, and only it's the Christmas is the only day we have off, and so every day is the same difference. So I'm like, whatever. It's one of those holidays I don't care about really. And so in front of you today, I ordered from my favorite Chinese restaurant in this section of the city here. And so I remembered that I haven't ordered Chinese food at all for this 2 weeks. Like, I've done pizza, I've done sushi, have I done fried chicken? I don't even remember. It's all been a blur. And so I remembered I haven't done Chinese food before. And so, yeah. And so you guys notice the I haven't ordered dumplings because I actually, the only thing I don't like is I don't like the dumplings from these guys. So I ordered it last time, so I don't like it. So I didn't get it at this time. And so I only like dumplings from this one restaurant, but then I actually do not like their other food because their other food is kind of flavorless and only their dumpling is good. And so, yeah, so. Like I showed you earlier, this egg foo young is awesome. I did not know they put lettuce in egg foo young. I've never seen lettuce in egg foo young before. And you know, sometimes it's weird. It's like when I go to different Chinese restaurants here and there, like the fried rice too, it's like some places they put shredded lettuce in it. I'm like, lettuce and fried rice. I'm like, what the heck? Really, really nice. So basically, they call it their. This is like their house special fried rice. It got like a mix of shrimp and stuff like that in it. And then I've got some ginger chicken. It is basically battered pieces of chicken, and they fry it and they put it in the sauce. Like, before the corona. Me and my family, if we do not want to go to Chinatown for Chinese food, we like to come here too for real life, and so we really like the Chinese food here, the dine-in service as well. So, during the times of Corona, I like to support the restaurants that I like. So it's like by the time when they are open again, they're gonna still have some money and they can operate still. This one got a little bit of a weird, different sauce on it. It's like a pineapple sauce or something. Something different than your usual beef and broccoli. So it's like, I cannot believe it, my vacation time for 2 weeks, and even though the 2 weeks I bum around the house and I do absolutely nothing, the 2 weeks has gone by so fast. And honestly, it's besides dealing with my new bed, it's like getting the new bed is the only exciting thing, really, and so nothing else happened. I cannot believe you could just waste away the 2 weeks just like that. Ooh. They put these weird pieces of ginger, like the one they put in sushi, the ginger slices. Ooh. That's the weird taste I was tasting, is the ginger. Something different than the usual beef and broccoli. And so, about my bed, so the whole situation with my bed is now complete, it's now finished, and the bed is done. And so, because the last time the footboard was delayed shipping, right? So I called Wayfair and I'm like, Wayfair, what to do? They say it's delayed shipping and they don't know when. And then so the solution was the Wayfair. They sent me an extra footboard. And then so all of a sudden the footboard appeared out of the blue nowhere. And then, so the last few days, I was trying to call Wayfair to cancel the extra footboard because I do not want to deal with the return process when it comes to Canada. Because, like, these days, if it arrival to your place and the way things are these days, I don't know about the return policy, and they probably do not accept return once it arrived to your house. So when it's still in the US, I try to call them and stuff like that. So the phone call was like an hour wait almost. And then I said, oh, so can you guys just recall that item? And so I don't need it anymore. Can you cancel it for me, please? Like, I have no use for an extra footboard. So they did that for me, so I do not need to worry about it no more. And also my new cell phone is on the way. By the time you see this video, I should be using my new cell phone already. It should be arriving tomorrow morning, so I have to wait for the pay attention to the delivery. Oh yeah, that is the only other exciting thing that I did was I got a new phone, and And I went to the Samsung 10e. Is that a good phone, you guys? I have no idea. Is that a better phone than the Samsung 9? I have no idea. The offer was like way too good to refuse. It's like the $20 cheaper a month totally, and it's a new phone, and I got like 20 gigabytes of data. Usually for Canadians, we get very shitty cell phone plans, and usually we get ripped off, and usually every time we upgrade, we usually pay more money. So this is very weird. It's like to pay the $20 less. Like, I had to double check the offer to make sure they said 20 gigabytes of data, because, like, I've never had 20 gigabytes of data before. And then the next funny thing is too, because, I was thinking about going to the iPhone, but then it's like the iPhones are expensive. And like I told you guys before, it's like I am not a very important person, and in real life, the people doesn't really call me very much, and so there's really no point for me to get an expensive phone that like I'm gonna do nothing with. So the problem is now with the Samsung again is that I have to go and find a phone case, and the phone case is like a bitch to get for Samsung because all the phone cases out there is for iPhones usually. Like, you know, if you want to get the bling bling phone cases, the more attractive ones, they usually it is for the iPhones. Really, really nice Chinese food, and not too salty. You could actually taste the flavor. Some restaurants, they make their food so salty, it's that you cannot even taste the food. Water. So after that I uploaded the weekly vlog, I have no other videos left to do for now. Thank you guys so much for supporting my channel. I was worried that people will be bitching about the video that is too long, blah blah blah. You guys, like I say, it's very nice to me all these years. Like, whatever video that I do, you guys are so nice to me. Like, sometimes with some of the bigger YouTubers, right? Like, the bigger ones, like, if they pick their nose the wrong way or they do this or do that, the viewers would be all over them. I knew that I was wanting to order delivery today, So if you notice, I'm eating faster because I'm actually hungry and I purposely did not eat anything really today. It is the last day of my vacation time from work, and so I want to eat something good. I want to treat myself something good. This is really delicious egg foo young. I like to remind you guys that it is very important to not only support the national chain restaurants, but you need to support the local small restaurants too. Oh, and lately these days, I've been, I kind of sort of left the American YouTube community, the American channels. I sort of stopped watching the American channels. This last week or so, I started to watching the Taiwan YouTubers a lot. I really enjoy the Taiwan, the YouTube community. Because at first I discovered this a Taiwan girl, and she does like a tour guide job and stuff like that, and she talks about travel and stuff like that, and she specializes in travel in the Asia area. And then I started to, you know, the way YouTube works is when you watch one video, then they recommend you other videos and stuff like that. And then so the other Taiwan YouTubers started to pop up here and there. It is so interesting, like the YouTube community for Taiwan is so vibrant. It's like when they do a lot of collabs with each other. Like I recognize this one YouTuber, and then they go with this other YouTuber, and then they do this, they do that, they do that, and I find they do a lot of collabs and stuff. At the moment, I find the Taiwan, the YouTube community is more exciting than the American one. So yeah, I kind of stopped watching American YouTubers. It is so funny, it's that I've got hours and hours and hours of content to watch. Like for heaven's sake. Even the president of Taiwan, the Tsai Ing-wen, she has her own YouTube channel as well. Yeah, all I've been eating the whole day is Oreo cookies. Yeah, like this year is like totally, it's like off the rocker this year. It's like 2020. It is supposed to be the year that me and my mom, we supposed to go to Taiwan for vacation this year. And so that is canceled. And the other thing that I had planned was I bought tickets to the Celtic Woman concert, and it is supposed to be tomorrow, the Celtic Woman concert, but that got canceled as well. And so, I don't know, basically the 2020 has been all canceled. And so, I don't know, but then hopefully next year should be a better year. And so, coming September would be my 12 years at my job. And so, it is the first time in 12 years that I actually canceled a vacation plan, that I'm actually doing nothing. And so, yeah, it is so weird, you guys. And so, yeah, so Chinese food is done. Chinese food is good, and it gobbled it up quite quickly. So, thank you so much for tuning in today, guys. And don't forget to check out all my other older videos on my playlist on my channel. And I will see you in the next one. Hey guys, so today it is Tuesday, May 19, 2020, and so this is the sort of like a vlog. I'm like doing a one day vlog today, and so I felt like it, and so yeah. So I just had my ch leftover Chinese food for breakfast, and it is almost 11:30, and so I am so disappointed because this is my new cell phone. And so when I called the phone company and I asked them about it, and the girl said to me that the package is an insured product, and so the Canada Post would never just leave it at the door and just go. And so about 15 minutes ago, I checked and there was nothing. And then I just went to take out some garbages to the bins outside, and I went back home, and the box was just sitting at the doorstep in the front door. And I'm like, what the heck? It's like the girl from the phone company told me that it's an insured product, and so they're gonna never leave it at the door, but they still did it anyways. And I'm like, so annoyed. So I never do this in real life, but because of the circumstances, I always change the phone at the store, and the guy at the store helped me switch over the phone. But this is my first time ever doing it by myself. I am just so mad with Canada Post, but I don't know, but it's like, at least I got my phone, and I'm gonna be going to work later, and so I can't believe they did that. So I know in Canada we're pretty low class, the low tech with the cell phone. So this is the SIM card that comes out. That's the with my phone number. Yeah, normally when I get the new cell phone, I would just go to the store because I'm old school. And so, thanks for sticking with us. And so, to activate your new SIM. Okay, I'm gonna figure this out. Like, I do not want to be laughing joke when I switch the phone, but this is like way high tech for me. Who knows? It might be a popular video. How an Asian switches over a new phone. But you know, on another hand, is I am glad that they just left it there because I do not want to make an extra trip to the post office to pick it up. Ooh, sexy. This is what it looks like. And this is the charger for it and the headphones and the cable for the charger. Maybe. How the heck did they put it like that? Oh my gosh, I'm hopeless. Maybe I'm gonna be going to work a bit earlier. Maybe I'm gonna ask one of the younger kids at work to help me switch the phone. I'm like, can you help Grandpa to fix the phone for me, please? And so maybe I'm just gonna do that. I'm just gonna be an old fart and just get one of the younger kids to help me. All right, you guys. And so, yeah. So I got my new phone. So, yeah.